To continue this discussion, we're joined now by Elizabeth Kirk, Associate Scholar at the Charlotte Lozier Institute and the Director of Center for Law and the Human Person at Catholic University of America. Elizabeth, thanks for joining me. You recently wrote an article at Public Discourse where you explained that the Value in Both Amendment failed because it's difficult to communicate complex legal and political principles. Could you explain that a little bit more?
Sure. Many people don't realize that the Kansas constitutional amendment effort was not an affirmative pro-life effort. Rather, it was a reaction to a very extreme decision by the Kansas Supreme Court. Back in 2019, the court held that there was a state constitutional right to abortion, and they adopted this very strict test under which nearly all existing and future abortion legislation will likely be struck down. And there are only two ways to correct a bad Supreme Court decision. Either a future Supreme Court has to overrule it, or the people have to pass a constitutional amendment. And so that's all that the Value Them Both Amendment was about, was removing this judicially invented right to abortion and restoring to the people the right to legislate in this area. But because so few abortion laws had actually been struck down so far, pro-choice advocates were able to kind of step in and create a lot of confusion, and pro-life advocates were on their heels trying to explain this complicated Supreme Court decision, strict test they adopted, the way that it would apply, and abortion advocates were able to take advantage of that confusion and scare voters that it would lead to a total ban on abortion. Stop ban was a ubiquitous sign seen throughout Kansas in the weeks leading up to the election. So people were very confused about what gave rise to the need for it and what the amendment itself would do.
Right. And so how can we avoid that confusion in the future? You know, there are a couple of other states with upcoming ballot initiatives on pro-life measures this year, such as Michigan and California. Mm-hmm. What should our strategy be moving forward?
Well, I think it's first important to clarify that the amendment in Kansas was neutral on abortion. So again, all it would have done was restore to the people the ability to fashion abortion policy. The measures you mentioned, Michigan and California, they are full-throated efforts to constitutionalize unlimited access to abortion at any time for any reason at taxpayer expense. So that's one important thing to understand. I think the lessons we learned in Kansas is that we have to harness the emotional power of truthful stories and to expose the radical pro-abortion agenda. We can't be defensively reassuring voters that we're not going to throw women in jail for having a miscarriage, right? Instead, we need to make proponents of these initiatives own what it is that they're supporting, which again is unlimited access to abortion throughout pregnancy for any reason. And pro-life advocates, I think, can prepare themselves for this by educating themselves on the law, the science, the medicine, and share those stories in a compelling way that captures the imagination and the hearts of people.
And a spokesperson from Value Them Both, which is the predominant pro-life group that favored the Kansas amendment that failed, told Fox 4 News in Kansas City that their, quote, focus now is moving the cause of life forward in Kansas, not looking back to August 2nd. Do you think that's wise advice for the movement right now?
In Kansas, absolutely. I mean, I think they need to advance the cause of life in two ways in Kansas. One, of course, is to within the constraints of this terrible Supreme Court decision, try to advance pro-life policy in law. But second of all, they need to recognize that abortion, Kansas is going to become an abortion destination state. Abortions are already up in the state 13% since that bad Supreme Court decision. And so they're going to need to do more in terms of, compassionate resources available to women, alternatives to abortion to care for women who are coming into the state.
Elizabeth Kirk from Charlotte Lozier Institute and the Catholic University of America, thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.